I spent a whole morning watching YouTube videos, and most of the screen remained static for several hours. Was I seeing the monitor right? Could the YouTube interface get burned in on my Mac? Subtle, but it was really there. The place for the channel icon and subscribe button, the suggested videos list, the top bar, all marked in the screen. But how? The burn-in problem was pretty common with Phosphor CRT monitors of the 80s and 90s. Very often, those old computers ran the same program every day. Can you guess this one? Probably VisiCalc, Multiplan, or Lotus 123. Oh my god, am I old? It also happened to arcade machines. But if you think this is something from the past, you are wrong. It depends on the technology used on the display. For example, plasma TVs also use phosphor on their pixel cells and are prone to wear out unevenly if they show the same image long enough, like in the airport, or if you watch the same channel every day. OLED and AMOLED displays used on many new phones wear out too, so it is possible to end up with a permanent burned-in ghost image of your icons, or the clock, or the keyboard if you text a lot. On the Google Play Store, there are lots of apps for fixing or alleviating burn-in screen. LCD displays don't burn in. Instead, the liquid crystals kind of get stuck if showing the same image for long. It is called image persistence or image retention. Thankfully, it is temporary. A few hours turned off or a good screensaver and it gets back to normal. Maybe one day iPhones, iPads, or even Macs might abandon LCD screens, but right now LCDs still have advantages. They show more natural colors, use less battery, and won't burn in your icons, keyboard, or the YouTube interface. At least not forever. By the way, an LED monitor or TV is actually an LCD screen that is backlit by LEDs instead of a fluorescent tube lamp. If you want to know more about LCD, plasma, OLED, AMOLED, check the articles and videos I will link in the description. See you on the next video, and thanks for watching.